I felt that. I felt that. We're gonna hold out in the name of Jesus, okay? We gonna hold out. When your way gets weary, you can hold out in the name of Jesus. Thank you for sharing, Lady Nicole. Welcome. Thank you for sharing, Lady Shannon, Lady Andrea. Thank you so much. Thank you for those of you who have joined us on multiple platforms. God bless you, Lady Shatara, Lady Joyce. God bless you as well. Lady Nina, God bless you. Come on through. Y'all come on in the room. Come on in the room. Thank y'all for sharing and inviting. It's not too late. Go on ahead and do it. Sharing is caring. If you care, you share it. I believe it's been blessing y'all. So go ahead and be a blessing. Blessings to you, Lady Kia. Welcome, welcome. Yes, help is on the way. Blessing to you, Lady Tanise, as well as to you. And those of you who have joined us tonight, I'm so grateful for your presence. You know, this word was downloaded earlier today. It was amazing. It was like February 14, 2/14/21. And the word was at like 2:21 in the afternoon. Blessings to you, Lady Nappy Girl TV, Lady D. Welcome, welcome. She says she had a call. She was in the car getting her sister. Not sure if it was the man. She did say she could not hear, but call back. Could have heard her son-in-law. Wow. I believe that Father is moving. He's also speaking in the name of Jesus. And so as he's working, just be available. I'm telling you, anything can happen at any moment. Blessings to you, Lady DP Pouncy. Blessed always for sure. Hey, Lady Danielle, God bless you. Lady Sammy, hello. And so the thing about it is, like, anything can happen at any moment. And like earlier, I was pressing in and I was praying, and it was like this woman of God, she got engaged November, like out the blue. She had just, you know, it was supernaturally. And I'm telling you, this restoration, like, it is happening so quick. And so she was, you know, talking to Father about a wedding, da 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 da. And so she ended up speaking to and her name is Michelle. She ended up speaking to her fiance. Like 2 weeks ago, she said, and they were planning a trip. You know, she was thinking she was going to get married, you know, further off in the distance. And she was like, we're going to get married. And, you know, then they just started talking, and it was like, well, why not now? And so they were actually scheduled to get married tomorrow. They were actually scheduled to get married tomorrow. But due to the weather in Texas, they decided to go on ahead and do it today. Come on, somebody. They went ahead and did it today, a day early. Come on, which was actually even a day earlier than the early date that was planned. Can I tell you that this about to come so fast, your head is gonna swim. It's gonna be faster than you even anticipated, right? And so she's like, with the weather and everything, and you know, even still, it actually, instead of it being a delay, it ended up advancing the time. It ended up accelerating the time. Hello, somebody. And she hadn't even planned on it. But with that, like, she's like, y'all, I'm married on Valentine's Day. Like, that's not something that she had planned on, not something that she had thought of. But you know what? The Father made it happen. I'm telling you, it's happening so quickly. And so I just keep hearing, you know, testimonies, testimonials, and whatnot. And so for those of you, if I'm not able to get back to you as quickly as you think or you would prefer, number one, I have to be submitted to our Father. And there's times of consecration and whatnot. And so, you know, if I can't get back to you, it just, you know, that is, I would pray that you would trust, you know, because so many times I hear, thank you, Lady J, or thank you, Lady Jeremiah, for being obedient. And so I have to be obedient on all sides. And so if you're not getting a response, just trust that maybe he doesn't want me to respond at this time, quite possibly, because he's trying to work something in you that's going to strengthen your discipline, that's going to strengthen your walk, even with him, and your ability to hear. I'm telling you know, dreams are happening. I'm telling you, his words, his downloads are happening. And so I'm so excited about this letter today. Just to encourage those of you who are here, those of you who will catch this on the replay, those of you who this word is for. With the letters, you know, oftentimes, I'm realizing that it's a download. It's a complete download. So the whole letter may not be for you, or maybe there's a portion of it's for you. Take what you believe that hit you in your shondo, that's confirmation, that bears witness with your spirit, and go to our Father, and then ask him for details, for information, confirmation, and he will give it to you. So many times I hear, Lady Jeremiah, how am I supposed to know that it's him speaking? You know, that's something that you develop with time in the secret place. And one of the things that's encouraging is that with these letters, often you are hearing or feeling because it's something that you've said to him in prayer, or he's spoken to you, or you've journaled, or what have you. And so when that is happening, y'all tell me if we're freezing, because all of a sudden this screen is being, you know, weird. And so we ain't got time for that. And so with that, these letters are oftentimes a lot of opportunities for confirmation for you to realize that you have heard him in the secret place. So that increases your confidence. And so it's something that is going to come through time in his word, because he speaks through his word. And so as you read it, you'll be able to tune your ear to more clearly hear, because knowing that it's him that says that is so essential in this hour. The things that are going to happen in this world, and you're going to have to know him for yourself. You have to know him for yourself. You have to know his voice for yourself. He will give you voices at times. He will speak to you through others at times, but he really wants you to know him. And then when you get that word, because can't nobody shake you from what you know that you know that you know. You know, it's like, you know, you can, the Bible says in 2 Chronicles 20:20, believe in the Lord thy God, so shall you be established, believe his prophets, and so shall you prosper. And I'm telling you, I do believe that. I also understand that there are times when I know in my knower, and there's nobody who can tell me no different. Like, I just know that I know that I know. And there's nothing like being able to know that so for sure. In Jesus' name. So Lady Jeanette, she said today her prodigal showed up with a Valentine's present. Everything that was prophesied the last couple of days came to pass. Can't wait to see what's in store for this evening. Wow, I'm so grateful to our daddy, how he is just confirming his word. It's him, it's not me. I'm so excited. And so I'm telling you, she said, she had two marriage dreams last night, and truly believe that these letters from Father are what pushed her to pray deeper and helped her to believe. I'm telling you, he is faithful. And that's what I believe as well, is that, you know, being able to have these words that he is releasing, these letters and his love expressed, helps you to be able to pick up on his voice. Like, you will sense his presence when you're in the room. Not that I got, you know, no monopoly on anything like that. I'm so grateful that he favors us with his presence. And so that helps you be able to realize when you have that peace and his presence, and, you know, that confirmation that no, there's nothing like it, and no one can take it from you. And then, you know, earlier today, he was speaking to me about being aware of your spirit. Like, these settings like this, when you just feel him hovering, if there's anything that compromises that, it's so important for you to pick up on that and be like, okay, where is it shifting? Like, what happened, you know, so that you can identify, so that you can get right back in that place, and so that you can continue to hear clearly in Jesus' name. She said that Father restored her, restored today their relationship, and they confessed their love. You know, let's just give a moment to give our Father a great praise. This is Lady Jeanette testifying on YouTube. I'm telling you, he is so faithful in Jesus' name. And so we just honor our Father for the confirmations that are coming through for so many. Blessings to you, Lady Karen. Is it Armand Echoes? Welcome. But what happens when you know, but it doesn't happen? So if you feel like you know, first it's like, okay, Father, did I get something wrong? Okay, or what happened? You know, if there was something that you feel like threw it off, you know? And so that's the, again, where you build and cultivate the relationship, and you go to where the word came from. Welcome, Lady Ashley. So glad that you're here. You know, the woman of God in 2 Kings 4, who had received the promise from Elisha that she was going to have a child. You know, it was like, oh, wonderful, a miracle, wonderful, hallelujah, right? And so she has the child gets older, and then all of a sudden the child dies. You know, it's like, okay, hold on. I told the man of God, don't play with me, don't lie to me, don't get my hopes up or whatever. Now you done birthed this baby, and some of you have begun to birth the promise. You birthed the promise or whatever. And then, you know, if the bottom, what do you do? And she went literally back to the man of God where she had gotten the word from, because the voice of the Lord was speaking through him at that time. And you know what? He went, and that child was raised from the dead. I'm telling you, resurrections are happening. So if it's Father who gave you the word, go back to him. Okay, what happened? You know, here is my promise. I'm laying it before you in Jesus' name. And then not only can he identify what took place, but also, you know, are there instructions for me to know what I need to do? How do I proceed from here? I'm telling you, and Father is using these as opportunities to increase and promote communication with him. And because it's going to be so significant, it's going to be very imperative that you are able to communicate clearly. So he's giving you practice with him. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And so she says she's been reading that scripture since yesterday. I'm telling you, I just honor our Father. You know, there are times when he is just confirming his words so much where you have to know, you know, who he is speaking through for you at a particular time. Sometimes it's a season. Sometimes it's just for a reason. Maybe it's just a one-off. And then sometimes it's for a lifetime. And so it's so important to know where he's speaking a word that's for you. And not every word is for you. It may be through the same vessel. But it's so important. That's why obedience and submission, surrender to him is so important. So listen, still a good place to share. Welcome, welcome, those of you who are here. And so I'm just going to press in. This word tonight, and this letter tonight, should I say, is a word that is for those. And I'm going to start here with the scripture in Psalms chapter number 34, verse number 17 through 18. It says, the righteous cry out and he delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. There are some, you know, you have been feeling a little weary along the way. You are tired. Maybe you've even seeped into a little bit of a depression. You feel like it's hard to hold on. You know, you've just been, you know, you feel like you're getting weary from the weight, literally. And so it's saying the righteous, but so you've been also living right. You know, you've been living as best as you know to live, right? You've been doing everything you know to do. And so it says the righteous cry out and he delivers them from all their troubles. I want to encourage you tonight that Father delivers you from all your troubles. If it hasn't come, it's coming. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. Some of you feel like you're all alone, but I want to encourage you that our Father is close to you, especially if you feel like you're in a brokenhearted place, and he saves those. He saves them. He comes to your rescue. Those of you who are feel like you're crushed in spirit. Listen, Psalms 27 says this, starting at verse number 8. When you said to me, seek my face, my inner being responded, I'm seeking your face with all my heart. There are those of you where you feel like you received the instruction for you to seek the Lord's face, to call unto him, to cry out unto him, and you responded, I'm seeking your face with all my heart. With all my heart, everything in you has been seeking him. And so verse number 9, the psalmist is saying, so don't hide yourself, Lord, when I come to find you. Some of you feel like you've been trying to find him and you feel like he's hidden himself, like, where you at though? And so it says, you're the God of my salvation. How can you reject your servant in anger? Some of you have literally felt like you have been rejected, like, or he's rejecting you. He says, you've been my only hope, so don't forsake me now when I need you. Have you ever felt like God is forsaking you when you need him? Listen, and there are those of you who feel that way. Going on, it says, my father and mother abandoned me. I'm like an orphan, but you took me in and made me yours. Some of you feel like you've been abandoned by so many other people or what have you. And not only that, But the Lord, that's how you bonded with him, so much so, because when you realized you didn't have nothing else, he was all that you needed. And so you called unto him and you've been doing that. Listen, and he took you in and made you. He is now, teach me all about your ways and tell me what to do. You're like, teach me your ways. Okay, maybe I got it wrong. You're like, maybe I got it wrong. Twitter is saying it seems a little delayed. Anyone else feel like you've delayed or there's a delay in the recording? Because we ain't got time for that. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you right now. We take control over these broadcasts now in the name of Jesus. And we command for the internet to work the way it's supposed to in Jesus' mighty name. So for those of you, and so you feel like, you know, God, he took you in and now you're saying, teach me your ways. I want to know, I want to grow. I want to be ready. I need to know what's going on. You will fast when the bridegroom is not there. Lady Nina, God bless you. So it looks like maybe Periscope is having the trouble It's a delay in the video, but you can hear perfectly. Okay, so as long as y'all can hear perfectly, we good. Some people are saying that they're fine, so you might wanna go back out and come back in. It seems like it's just primarily Periscope, but YouTube, for the most part, it looks like they're good. So you might wanna go out and come back in. And so we're gonna continue. And so you're like, just Father, please tell me what to do. Make it clear for me to understand. Some of you have felt like you've received some instructions, but you are like, you know, I don't understand. I don't get it. I see different elements, but I don't understand. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do about it. That if you guys follow me on multiple platforms, it seems like YouTube is better. How are we doing on Facebook? Somebody comment so I can know. And so I want to continue with the word, because as long as you can hear, we're good. Listen, it ain't about no video. It's not about me anyway. And so you're like, Father, please make it clear for me to understand, for I am surrounded by waiting enemies. You feel like, you know, people just waiting on your downfall. Listen, they gonna be disappointed. Hello. And so it says, don't let them defeat me, Lord. You can't let me fall into their clutches. They keep accusing me of things I've never done, while they plot evil against me. You feel like, you know, there's just so much evil or wickedness going on around you. And so it looks like we're good on Facebook. To Father alone be all the glory. Blessings to y'all who have come in. Blessings to you, Lady Edvidge. And so listen, then this word is quite possibly for you. I want you to go into him. And so listen, again, this is about holding out and holding on in the name of Jesus. Again, it's about holding out and holding on. And so this is the letter. This is what I heard Father say. And then he led me to some other scriptures that he wants to speak to you with regarding that. And so he says, I know how you feel, daughter. I know how you feel, my son. I know what it feels to be or feel rejected too. If that's what you feel or what it seems, don't harden your heart. You've been asking me to just change you and to remove whatever is necessary so you don't keep messing up. And Father says, I've told you, I don't want you to change. I know your heart, and you don't have to change anything. Now, that's not for everybody, but that's for somebody. Blessings to you, Lady Beth. So, Father, because you've literally, the enemy has been trying to make you feel all this guilty. He has you being double-minded, going back and forth like you've messed up or you're too messed up, or, you know, you should have did this or you should have did that. And he's like, no. At this point for you, because you've already submitted, surrendered, he's already been processing you. You're in a different place now. You're in a different place now. So where you are, when your heart is pure, and you know, even if things go left while your heart is pure though, and you've been walking uprightly, that's another situation. I mean, you got to make sure you keep your heart pure and in the right place. But he's saying there are some of you, not all, but there are some of you where, you know, you've been asking him to change you, remove whatever is necessary. Mm-hmm. And some of you, just that posture and that place, our Father is saying, listen, it's not that I want you to change. You don't have to change anything. He says, just keep going. Don't give up. Endure. Keep on. He says, in Jesus' name, he says, keep crying out to me. I hear you, and trust me. You've almost been pleading. He says, just trust me. So, and as he was saying this, thank you, Holy Spirit, for bringing back to my remembrance. As he's saying, just keep going and don't give up, endure, keep at it. He began to actually cry, as to cry with you. Like, that's what I saw in my spirit, in my vision. Like, he was literally weeping. And as he began to cry, like, and almost pleading with you to just trust me, he says. Just trust me. Don't give up on me. Don't give up on us. Don't give up on what it is that I has promised. Don't give up. Hang in there. Hang in there, my daughter. Hang in there, champ, he says to his sons. Keep putting, hallelujah, keep putting your trust in me. Keep on hoping in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You are getting to trust me again, to love again. I'm making it all work. I make all things beautiful in my time. My time is coming. Trust in me. Trust in me. Hold on. I am faithful. I will show you and I will make it up to you. Then, Father, led me to Psalms chapter number 91. In the Message translation, it reads, "If you'll hold on to me for dear life, says God, I'll get you out of any trouble." Whatever trouble you feel like you're going through, whatever you feel like you got going on, he says, "If you'll hold on to me for dear life, says our Father, I'll get you out of any trouble, like I want to say every trouble. I'll give you the best of care. If you'll only get to know and trust me, call me and I'll answer. Be at your side in bad times. I'll rescue you, then throw you a party." Listen, he says, "I'll rescue you and then throw you a party. I'll give you a long life and give you a long drink of salvation." That means his saving power. That means to be rescued in every way in Jesus' name. And he says, "I'll give you a long life." That's for somebody, you know, the enemy has been threatening you, like your life may be cut short, or maybe you experience some sickness or illness or even a disease. Father is saying to for you to hold on to that word, that he's going to give you a long life. You shall live and not die and declare the works of the Lord in Jesus' name. And so Father says in the Passion Translation, as he wanted me to read it to you tonight, it says, "For here is what the Lord has spoken to me." Listen, I got to tell you, back to that part where he says, "I'll rescue you, then throw you a party." That's back to that congratulations. You can expect it is coming. You're going to have a reason to celebrate. I just declare that over you right now in Jesus' name. Listen, and so in the Passion Translation, Psalms 91 verse 14 says, "For here is what the Lord has spoken to me." It says, "Because you have delighted in me as my great lover." He looks at you as his great lover. You're, the way you love him like that, because you've delighted in me as your great lover, I will greatly protect you. He is your protection. I will set you in a high place, safe and secure before my face. Listen, and so those who you felt like was waiting for your down, no, you're going to be safe and secure before his very face in the name of Jesus. Father says, "I will answer your cry for help every time you pray." Oh, that's a good place right there. He says, "I will answer your prayer every time you pray. I will answer your cry for help every time you pray. And you will find and feel my presence even in your time of pressure and trouble. I will be your glorious hero and give you a feast." Listen, he is looking to be your hero. You can trust in him in Jesus' name. And not only that, but he says, "And I'll give you a feast." They had feasts when it was time to celebrate in the name of Jesus. And it says, "You will be satisfied with a full life," with a full life. Come on, somebody, Brother Chris, you will be satisfied with a full life in the name of Jesus. Those of you who are on here, you will be satisfied with a full life, because some of you feel like your time is going to be cut short, or maybe you're not going to have that long to enjoy. But he is saying, "You will be satisfied with a full life." The long life, not only long, but full. That means it's not empty. That means it's hitting on every level and every is full. Listen, it's not void. It's not empty in Jesus' name. And he says, "And with all that I do for you," you will be satisfied with all I do for you. Not only a long, full life, but all that I do for you, for you will enjoy the fullness of my salvation, saith Father. And then he led me to these quotes. And so with that, because again, he says, "I'm speaking in the titles." And so it says, "Be a Ruth, loyal in all your relationships. Walk the extra mile and don't quit when things get tough." Like, listen, she was with Naomi and Orpah even walked off, but she didn't quit. Even though things had gotten tough, she had lost her husband, she would become a widow and everything, she kept on going. It says someday you'll see why it was all worth the effort. There's confirmation right there that it's going to be worth the effort. It's going to be worth the wait in Jesus' mighty name. And so listen, you are so blessed. No matter what you are going through now, know that Father is already causing all these to work together for your good. What has been initially intended to bring you down will turn around for your favor and God. Hallelujah. Your favor in our Father in Jesus' name. It's going to turn around for your favor in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare it according to Genesis 50 and 20, according to Romans 8:28. And then it says, what is coming is better than what is gone. Listen, what is coming before you is better than what is being in the name of Jesus. He has greater. Hallelujah, that is in store. Listen, the 1 John 4:4 says, the Lord is greater than the giants you face. Listen, that's a quote inspired by that verse. And I'm telling you, whatever giants you face, and you know, he was talking about giants the other day, he is far greater than them in the name of Jesus. Because if God be for you, he is greater than the enemy. He's greater than any of the world that is trying to come against you in Jesus' name. Anything that has tried to defeat you, he is greater. If God be for you, he is greater than the world against you. Come on, somebody. And so I could see these words that Father was using and going to say, and it was like as I said different words and what he showed me in the spirit, because some of you have been saying different words, you've been speaking different things, right? And then, you know, you get to questioning if that was the right thing to say, if it was the right time to say it. And Father is saying that there are some words that you have released, and he is using those words. They're being used by angels as healing instruments, and the instruments to perform surgery on hearts. Some of you have been made to feel guilty for saying certain things, like, or your words were used against you. And Father is saying tonight that he is using those words, that he is causing his angels to go forth and use those words as actual healing instruments. And I could see them as instruments to perform surgery on hearts. And so it was like covering. It was also like thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. It was also like, you know, using them to stitch hearts back together, if that makes sense. And so he was closing things up. So he was utilizing them as instruments in the healing process, and literally to do surgery as well in Jesus' name. And so he says, they are being used by me. Nothing more, nothing less. In timing, listen and obey. Some of you will receive instructions. And Father is saying, move forward in the instructions that I've given you, and to say nothing more and say nothing less, and do it in my timing. Listen and obey. Don't delay, but make sure you are sure. Make sure you have heard it from me in the name of Jesus. And that's what our Father is saying unto you tonight. Hallelujah. And that's what he wants you to gather. That's what he wants you intent on tonight in the name of Jesus. And then he led me to Joshua chapter number 21, verse number 45. And I'm going to read that out of the Message translation tonight. And the word of the Lord says this. It says, not one word failed from all the good words God spoke to the house of Israel. Everything came out right. Can I tell you on tonight in the name of Jesus that not one word has, nor will it fail. Hallelujah. Of all of the good words that Father spoke to you as well, everything came out right. And just like everything came out right, everything for you is going to come out right for as well in the mighty name of Jesus. And then he led me to Joshua chapter number 23. I'm going to be reading the word, because he's speaking through his word in the name of Jesus. Sometimes, you know, we want to hear a word from somebody else. And I'm telling you, he says, no, I want to talk to them. I want to walk them through my word. And so Joshua chapter number 23, starting at verse number 8, I'm in the Message translation. And it says, hallelujah, don't so much as speak the names of their gods or swear by them. And by all means, don't worship or pray to them. Hold tight to God, your God, just as you've done up to now. Listen, there are some of you, you know, that you've encountered some, and he's saying, no, stay focused. Don't make no idols. Don't speak the names of no other gods. Don't resort back to old behaviors. But it says, hold tight to God. That sounds like hold on to me. Hold tight to God, your God, just as you've done up till now. You've been holding on up till now. That's why you're on here right now. Listen, and he's saying, keep holding on tight to him in the name of Jesus. It goes on to say, God has driven out superpower nations before you. God has already taken out so many things before you. He's done it before. And I'm telling you, he will do it again. He is moving. He is working in the name of Jesus. Now listen, hallelujah. And then it goes on to say, and up to now, no one has been able to stand up to you. Think of it. One of you single-handedly putting 1,000 on the run. And God has gathered us together to be in the spirit of agreement. Listen, to come together and agree and pray and release his heart. And then it goes on to say, because God is God, your God, because he fights for you, just as he promised you. You need to know tonight, because he's God, because he's your God. That's the reason why he's doing it. That's the way you've been able, reason why you've been able to accomplish what you've been able to accomplish, because he fights for you, just as he promised you. He made you a promise, and he's saying, I'm a promise keeper. I'm going to do what I said. Verse 11 says, now vigilantly guard your souls. This is the time for you to guard your heart, guard your soul, guard your mind, guard your gates and your eye gates as well, so the enemy is not able to operate. And earlier he told me, suffer not a witch to live. Suffer not a witch to live. You don't have time to entertain anything. Listen, because you have to guard your heart, guard your mind with all due diligence, guard your peace. Come on, somebody. And so he's saying, now vigilantly guard your souls. Love God, your God, because if you wander off and start taking up with these other nations and other stuff that's still among you, intermarrying, in other words, just say, settling, being with whoever, and have other dealings with them, know for certain that God, your God, will not get rid of these nations for you. In other words, this is not the time to settle or tolerate other things. Listen, so that you can trust him to finish the work. It said, there'll be nothing but trouble to you, horsewhips on your backs and sand in your eyes. Somebody, you need to know, it's not time for you to entertain certain people. It's not time for you to entertain certain conversations. Come on, somebody, until you're the ones who will be driven out of this good land that God, your God, has given you. You've already begun to take territory. And he's saying, I need you to stay focused so you don't lose it, so you're not driven out. And then it goes on, as you can see, I'm about to go the way we all end up going. This is Joshua speaking to them. Know this with all your heart, with everything in you, that not one detail has failed of all the good things God, your God, promised you. And when God says something again, when God has something written in his word more than once, should I say, that's something that he wants you to give attention to. He wants you to hear it. He means it. Come on, somebody. And he said, listen, he was about to make his transition. And, you know, and my responsibility is to try to deliver as much as what Father wants me to, you know, to be faithful, to give what he's given, and then to do my part to help you, so that if I'm gone, if I'm not here, listen, if Father has me on another assignment, that you have what you need to continue thriving and grow. It's not for me to bring you to myself, but for me to drive you to the Master, to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, our Father, hallelujah, for you to be able to have that relationship so you are not lost. And Joshua, before he leaves, he's like, look, yo, I'm about to go the way we all end up going. And for y'all, I pray that it's promotion, it's your shift, it's your new place, it's your next place. Come on, somebody, hallelujah, it's your place of promise, your place of purpose, your place of, hallelujah, even destiny. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Yeah, it's your place of promise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And somebody, he's delivering you out of promiscuity, even now in the name of Jesus. He says, from promiscuity to promise in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And so he says, know this with all your heart, with everything in you, that not one detail has failed of all the good things God, your God, promised you. And so if he ain't failed you yet, he's not going to fail you now. It has all happened. Nothing's left undone, not so much as a word. So he's not going to fail now, beloved. It in the name of Jesus. But just as sure as everything good that God, your God, has promised has come true, so also God will bring to pass the other things, until there's nothing left of you in this good land, all the bad things, until there's nothing left of you in this good land that God has given you. In other words, don't get to your good place and forget him. Don't get to shift him. Don't get to change it. When things start going good, you got to maintain. And he says, if you leave the path of the covenant of God, then because God has made a covenant with you. When he could swear by none greater, he swore by himself. It says, if you leave the path of the covenant of God, because many of you, God has made a promise to you. He's made a covenant with you. You've come into covenant with him. And if you leave that, the one God, the covenant of God, your God, that he commanded you, and go off and serve and worship other gods. And you know, that's a little G God, anything that, you know, you try to put in his place, even if that is your promise, don't make an idol out of it. It says, because God's anger will blaze out against you in no time, that at all, there'll be nothing left of you. No sign that you've ever been in this good land he gave you. That's a warning for somebody. That's instruction for you. You so that you don't end up shifting and, you know, getting brand new. I mean, the Father is speaking to you, and he wants you to know, listen, don't get brand new. Don't leave. Don't move from the place where he has you and where he has had you. Make sure you maintain your relationship with him. Make sure you are careful to take heed to the word that he has given you in the mighty name of Jesus. And then he took me over to Joshua chapter number 24. And I'm going to read that in just one second. Thank you, Father. Have your way. Have your way. Your will be done. Your word be released upon us tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. And for that, we give you glory. And we say thank you tonight. You alone are worthy. You alone are awesome in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. So then in Joshua chapter number 24, verse number 14, in the Message translation, it reads as this. It says, so now fear God, worship him in total commitment. The Father is giving us instruction tonight that you make a shift, because now it's time for you to fear him. Hallelujah. Which means give absolute reverence to him and worship him in total commitment. Your commitment to him, complete, total, reckless abandon in commitment to him and faithfulness and obedience, that is worship. That is worship. And he also is asking, or he also is looking for you to worship him. Get back to that place of worship and praise. Too many of you, you know, you've been down, and you've been, if you got to just turn worship music on, hallelujah, it's one thing to praise and give him thanksgiving and all that's good or what have you, and get your groove on. But he's also saying he wants to bring you back to the heart of worship. In Jesus' name. And so it goes on to say, get rid of the gods your ancestors worship on the far side of the river, the Euphrates, and in Egypt. You worship God. Whatever other people trying to do, however they trying to rock, whatever, you know, Father is saying, no, you worship me. No, you fear me. That's what I'm looking for you to do. I'm looking for you to fear me. Then in verse number 25, it says, Joshua completed a covenant for the people that day there at Shechem. Again, it was a covenant that they were making. It said he made it official, spelling it out in detail. Joshua wrote out all the directions and regulations in the book of the revelation of God. And Father is saying that he has been giving you instruction. He's been spelling it out in detail, and it is official. The things that he has spoken, his covenant, that it's official. And so it says not only the directions, but also the regulation. There are some things that Father expects of you. And so they were put into the book of the revelation of God. Then he took a large stone and set it up under the oak that was in the holy place of God. In other words, he made a memorial stone and a witness in Jesus' name. And because it is heard, every word that God has said to you, Father has said to you, and it is standing, hallelujah, witness against you, lest you cheat on your God. Father says he is taking it seriously. Don't cheat on him. Don't go after other gods. He says, because he has put Raboshata, he has made a promise to you, and he's going to keep his promise. And you know, when you go off and you follow your own way and you're misled and you start rocking with other things or whatever, and you put other, you are cheating on him. And he is like, no, you don't cheat on me because I'm good to you. You don't cheat on me because I'm good to you. And so I have to release that, because, you know, when you really love, you might not care if other people do what they do, but when you really love somebody, if they go off on you, it's a whole nother level. If y'all ain't rocking, like, it's a whole nother level of relationship. And so Father is saying, no, don't cheat on me, because I have made, and I am recovenanting with you tonight. In Jesus' name, even as we have said that word twice, like literally, he's saying, I'm renewing my covenant, my promise to you right now in the name of Jesus. So Father, I thank you for renewing your covenant with your people even in this moment. I ask that you will forgive us of the things that we have done that you are that were not pleasing to you. I ask that you will forgive us, Father, for having hearts and mindsets that were not of you or were not pleasing to you, for not being obedient. And Father, I ask that you will forgive us. And I thank you, Father, as we repent tonight. And I thank you, Father, that you are a redeemable shout. Thank you for your forgiveness even now in the name of Jesus. And Father says he is restoring you even now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And so Father, we come into covenant with you even as you still plan. Father, we will obey. Hallelujah. We will obey. We desire to please you in all that we say and do, Father, and we desire for our obedience, Father, to be worship even unto you as well in Jesus' name, that it will be a sweet smelling savor. Help us to obey you, Father, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you and we give you glory even now in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Then he led me to 1 John chapter number 4, verse number 7. Again, he is speaking through his own word tonight. And so we're just going to follow, hallelujah, as he is releasing his instruction to us in Jesus' name. And you can turn there with me. I'm going to read this out of the Passion Translation tonight. And it begins as this at verse number 7. It says, those who are loved by God, let his love continually pour from you to one another, because God is love. Because God is love. Thank you, Jesus. Everyone who loves is fathered by God and experiences an intimate knowledge of him. Listen, let me say that everyone who loves is fathered by God, listen, and experiences an intimate knowledge of him. If you don't feel like you've had it, this is your opportunity tonight to love like he loves, so as you are fathered by him. And so you will realize that an experience with an intimate knowledge of him is your portion in Jesus' name. Blessings to you, Dr. V. And so it goes on to say, the one who doesn't love has yet to know God. For God is love. The light of God's love shined within us when he sent his matchless son into the world so that we might live through him. This is love. Hallelujah. This is love. He loved us long before we loved him. It was his love, not ours. He proved it by sending his son to be the pleasing sacrificial offering to take away our sins. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And in the Greek, halasmos can be described as a cleansing, satisfying sacrifice that provides a covering shelter. Hallelujah. A form of the word is used for mercy seat. In other words, God's love provides the answers to life's greatest question. It's a covering. Hallelujah. His mercy seat was provided. And in the book of Romans, the word of the Lord says, hallelujah, that Jesus, even while we were yet sinners, Christ died for the ungodly. Listen, because the wages of sin were death, and so he took upon him a debt that he didn't deserve, to pay a price that you could not pay. You know, he rendered and he paid a debt that you couldn't pay, and he definitely didn't owe it. Listen, and so he proved it by sending his son to be the pleasing sacrificial offering to take away our sins. Delightfully loved ones, if he loved us with such tremendous love, then loving one another should be our way of life. The Father is saying to us tonight, he really wants you to know how deep his love is for you, how much you mean to him. And when you know how deep his love is for you, there are certain things you won't allow the enemy to lie to you about. Come on, somebody. And so understanding his tremendous love for you, then loving somebody else that even when they seem unlovable, whoever that is, you know, somebody, because he's looking for you to forgive. The word of the Lord says in Mark 11, chapter number 22, Mark chapter number 11, verse 22 to 26, it talks about, you know, have faith in God, and you know, he that believes can speak to this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, and it shall be done for him. But then it says, but if you have any ought against your brother, you need to go to him. It also says, if you have any doubt in your heart, you know, you cannot afford to doubt in this hour. That's why he wants you to know that you know that you know, and that's why he's extending this divine experience, hallelujah, of intimate knowledge with him so you will know, so you will not doubt in your heart in the name of Jesus. Because if you doubt in your heart, how dare you ask him for anything? Listen, and then if you have on your heart, he's like, go take care of that. And so, and then come back. And so Father is saying, I don't even want your offering until you take care of that. For so whoever has unforgiveness in your heart, you have not been loving. Father is saying, I need you to check that. I need you to check that. I need you to release it to me in Jesus' name. And some of you, he might actually give you instruction to reach out and be able to bridge that, whatever it is, to ask for forgiveness and to also forgive. Listen, and it says, so if you have been loved with such tremendous love, then loving one another should be a way of life, restoring someone who comes back into your life, you know, being able to forgive and move on and move forward, not throw it back up in their favor. Restoration in your relationship, not bringing something from an old season into what is now and what is to come in the mighty name of Jesus. And then it says, hallelujah, as it is our way of life, no one has ever gazed upon the fullness of God's splendor. And the Father is saying that there is somebody, you want him to restore your marriage, you want him to restore your relationship. But you're having a hard time getting over some things that happened. And Father is saying, no, I need you to check that. Because if you allow my love to flow through you, you will love properly and you will also receive love the way that the way that he desires for you to as well, in Jesus' name. So don't hold a grudge. Don't hold resentment against others in Jesus' name. So you're not caught up in yourself so that you can be able to extend the love of Almighty God, because they are going to need you to receive them in Jesus' name and receive them with the heart of our Father. So no one has ever gazed upon the fullness of God's splendor, but if we love one another, God makes his permanent home in us and we make our permanent home in him, and his love is brought to its full expression in us. He desires to love you in such a way that you know it so personally that you can express his love, hallelujah, even to others in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. She said it's on time, on timeline, but if he said it, it's true. Yes, absolutely. He said it. And so therefore he is a promise keeper in Jesus' name. And so if we love one another, God can make his permanent home in you and you make your permanent home in him, and his love is brought to its full expression in us. Father is saying you have to forgive. You have to forgive whoever you felt like was wrong or at fault or what have you. You also have to forgive even outside influence as well in Jesus' name, so your heart can remain pure. It ain't about them, it's about you not having any offense taken up in your heart in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You got to deal with that fault, that blame and all that, whatever, and render forgiveness in Jesus' name. And he has given us his spirit within us so that we can have the assurance that he lives in us and that we live in him. If you have not been filled with the Holy Spirit or you're not sure, then ask him for the evidence of speaking in a heavenly language, speaking in tongues in Jesus' name. And so listen, hallelujah, because his spirit living within you is also going to empower you to do these things, to love like Jesus, even sacrificially. Because some of you, it's like, but I did this and this, this and this, you know, and you feel like, you know, it should be different. You feel like you're owed something. You feel like, you know, and Father is saying, no, that's not how I work. I deal with you, you know, in Jesus' name. And so he's not looking, you know, to settle scores like that, if that makes sense. He is looking to make sure you are in the right place in him so that he can do everything that he desires to do in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And so it goes on to say this: moreover, we have seen with our own eyes and can testify to the truth that Father God has sent his son to be the savior of the world. Those who give thanks that Jesus is the son of God live in God and God lives in them. Listen, he is desiring to take a residence in you and in your heart and in your mind. And he says you have to make room for that. Listen, and so if you're playing the blame game, if you're all in your feelings, you're not going to be able to flow as freely as he is looking for you to flow in Jesus' name. And so Father is looking. He is looking for you to lay it upon him, for you to give it all to him in the mighty name of Jesus, because he is able to do anything but fail. In the name of the Lord thy God, in Jesus' name, Kondoboshata, in the name of Jesus. And so I believe right now, hallelujah, that Father, hallelujah, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Father, I just decree and declare your peace right now. Hallelujah. I bind all the works of darkness, all the confusion, all the distractions right now in the name of Jesus, Father, and we rest in you. Hallelujah. We rest in what you're speaking because you're doing a great work even now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because this is the time to forgive. This is the time to release in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, thank you for your spirit. Thank you for your presence. Those who are asking for you to fill them, Father, I pray right now that they would be received the gift of Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. And if there's anything, Father, because you will not dwell in an unclean temple, I pray that you would reveal it to us in Jesus' name so that we can do what needs to be done. Reveal it to us in the mighty name of Jesus because we want to be right in you. I hear that song right now. I want to be right. I want to be saved. I want to be whole. Listen, hallelujah. And we're looking for him to render unto you, render unto us clean hearts. Hallelujah. Who can ascend to the Most High? Those who have clean hands and a pure heart. Father is dealing with your heart as well, even right now in the name of Jesus. He wants you to love how he loves. He wants you to receive his love in Jesus' name. He is looking to purify your heart so that you can lift clean hands in Jesus' name. Let me continue. So those who give thanks that Jesus is the Son of God, live in God and God lives in them. We have come into an intimate experience with God's love, and we trust in the love he has for us. He is looking for you to trust in his love for you. Trust in him. Listen, you cannot love without trusting. You cannot love without trusting in Jesus' name. And so Father is looking for you to express your love to him by your trust in him, that he is going to do what he said that he was going to do in the mighty name of Jesus. And we decree it and declare it. Hallelujah. Father, thank you for opening up our eyes to see what we desire to see in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So that we can, yes, absolutely remain in a place, in a position to be able to pray. Hallelujah. Yes, create in us a clean heart. Renew within us a right spirit. Hallelujah. Renew the minds in the name of Jesus, even now in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. When you trust in him, you won't have to be guarded because you trust in what he has spoken and what he has said in Jesus' name. When you allow Holy Spirit to lead you and guide you, you know that you're not going to be set up for the okie doke. And if there's anything that comes up, that he is going to reveal all things to you in Jesus' name. And so God is love. Those who are living in love are living in God. He wants you to live in his love, abide in his love, and God will live through you. By living in God, hallelujah, God lives through you. God lives through them. By living in God, love has been brought to its full expression in us so that we may fearlessly face the day of judgment because all that Jesus now is, so are we in this world. All that Jesus is, so are you in this world. This is why it's important for you to know who you are in him, to receive your identity as a child of God and to know his love for you. Then you know that even as Jesus said, the works that I do, even greater works than these shall you do. Listen, and so Father is looking to work in you, even that expression. And he looks for you to be able to do it fearlessly, without reservation, because you know without a shadow of a doubt whose you are and your identity in him. And the devil can't have you in this condemnation and shame. And so I speak to your consciousness now that you would be able to have a clear conscience before the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, we decree it and declare it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Do it now according to your purpose, your will, and your plan in Jesus' name. And so those of you who are on here, be not distracted even now. Make sure you get what you've come here for, what you've been sent here for in the name of Jesus. Sometimes we're so busy speaking and we keep on recanting. You keep on saying what you've already seen. You keep on saying what you've been through instead of declaring what you desire to see. Life and death is in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat its fruit. So what do you love? You love the breakthrough. Start speaking a breakthrough and speak those things that be not as though they they were already, so that they shall be and they will be. Hallelujah. And it will not be otherwise in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And so I release it upon you now that you begin to declare the word of the Lord, the works of the Lord, what you desire to see in this earth. And if you begin to say what you desire to see, you begin to see the things that you are saying, that which you have said in Jesus' name. Absolutely fixed, forward, focused. And it's time to set your face like a flint in Jesus' name and be focused in him and what Father is saying in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Obedience is key. Obedience is key in the name of Jesus. Let's refocus. Let's refocus and let's hear what Father has to say. Not all the side conversations. You want to be clear in what Father has to say. We can speak to people all the time, but we really need to hear what he has to say, even in this moment, in Jesus' name. I don't want you to miss what you are here for in Jesus' name. And Father is rendering a word to you, and you might miss it if you're so busy talking. So many times we're so busy talking that we don't hear what he's saying. We're busy talking at him instead of being in his presence, hearing what he has to say, or asking questions that we need answers to, because he will answer you in Jesus' mighty name. And so, hallelujah, all that Jesus now is, so are we in this world. Love never brings fear, for fear is always related to punishment or judgment. Listen, hallelujah. So if you're feeling fearful, if you're feeling anxious, if you're feeling kind of, those are not of Father. He doesn't do that. If he is going to correct you, it is lovingly. He does it out of the spirit of love in Jesus' name. He does chastise those who he loves, but you know it. And he's also doing it with a reaffirming word and grace and love, and it's different. And so, because it says love never brings fear, you have to know that. And so if you are feeling this type of way, it's either the enemy, or it's a door that you have opened, or it's something that you are personally dealing with, and you need to give that over to the Lord, so that you don't allow that to be a way that the enemy can try to work in your mind and your thoughts. In Jesus' name, he's looking for you to renew your mind. Hallelujah. You have to renew your mind, and you do that especially when you know what is of Father and what is not. And fear isn't, in Jesus' name. Love never brings fear, for fear is always related to punishment. So if you feel that, you know it's not him. And so you need to start declaring against that spirit of fear, that, you know, things ain't going to change. The devil is a liar. Things are going to change in Jesus' name. When you start hearing things that are contrary, speak at it. Don't remain silent. This is a time for you to not let the devil have the last word in Jesus' name. Open up your mouth so that our Father will fill it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. She says she's literally working up to a letter every morning. She loves it. To Father alone be the glory. And so listen, but love's perfection drives the fear of punishment far away from our hearts. Love perfection. When you have been made perfect in his love and you receive his love, hallelujah, and you're clear, it's going to drive out the fear that, oh, boy, did I do wrong or whatever. It reminds me of somebody once said, you know, there are two types of people, you know, and let's say they're a teenager and they borrowed their parents' car, whatever, and they got into an accident. One is saying, oh no, I gotta call my dad. And the other one is like, oh no, I gotta call my dad. You know, he is looking for us to look to him, that no matter what it is, no matter how bad it is, and no matter how many pep talks he gave you before you might have messed something, but that you know that he is the one who's going to fix it, and you love him. And because of relationship, I got to tell my daddy the truth. I'm looking for him to move in Jesus' name. And so he says love's perfection drives out the fear of punishment. It drives, because some of you are so busy feeling like you're going to get it wrong, you're afraid of negative consequences. And he's like, no, let my love drive that out of you and away from you. Because when you trust in me and you've been made perfect in love, you're not going to have to worry about the end result and the consequence, because you're going to trust me to do what needs to be done. I am God, and I will make up the difference. I will make up the heads. That's why I say, trust me, trust me. She said, right, it's an insurance commercial, I'm telling you. And so it says here, whoever walks constantly afraid of punishment has not reached love's perfection. If the enemy has you always afraid of fear of correction, being corrected, or punishment, or being rejected, You have not been made perfect in love. You haven't reached love's full perfection. And so you say, Father, do a work in my heart so that I can feel your love. I can know without a shadow of a doubt that you love me more than anything. Hallelujah. And so I don't have to be in this place of fearing what could go wrong, because I know that you hold tomorrow in your hand. I don't have to be afraid for tomorrow because I know you got it covered. I know you go before me. I don't have to be afraid of the pestilence, come on, by day. Neither the you don't have to be afraid of any of that. Come on, Psalms 91, you can trust in the Lord your God. So our love for others is our grateful response to the love God first demonstrated to us. And so when you realize that his love is in you and it's so great, it's so, you don't have a problem loving others in Jesus' name, because you know what he has already done within your own heart already. Listen, hallelujah. Anyone can say, I love God, yet have hatred towards another believer. This makes him a phony, because if you don't love a brother or sister whom you can see, how can you truly love God who you can't see? Some of you have been feeling a type of way and is mad at people, you know, or maybe you're holding grudges or you're frustrated or you just haven't been able to let it go. But how can you say you love God whom you haven't seen and you hate your brother that you've seen or your sister that you see? Listen, and so how can you truly love God who you can't see? For he has given us this command: whoever loves God must also demonstrate love to others. The Father is looking for you to demonstrate his love to others in Jesus' name. Blessings to you, Lady Bianca. Thank you so much for the super award. Lady Rachel, may the blessing of the Lord overtake you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And so then Father led me to Revelations chapter number 2, verse number 25. Hallelujah. In the New King James Version, it says this. It says, but hold fast what you have till I come. Again, this is about holding out. This is about holding on in Jesus' name. And he says, hold fast to what you have until I come. He is looking for you to hold on to everything that he has put within you, that he has placed in you, hallelujah, until he comes, until he shows up. Hold on to that promise that he's put within you until he comes, until he shows up in Jesus' name. I'm going to read this right now out of the Message translation as well. In verse number 25, it reads as this, hallelujah. It says, hold on to the truth you have until I get there. Father has spoken to you. He has rendered words to you in Jesus' name, and he is looking for you to hold on to the truth that you have known. You know that his promises are true, that they are yes. Hold on to that. Don't let it go in the name of Jesus. You don't have time to play around with the devil. The previous verse says, and it says that gets paraded as profundity. Be assured that our Father will not make life any harder for you than it already is. I need you to be clear that our God, our Father, is not going to make life any harder for you than it already is. Hold on to the truth you have until I get there, says our Father. Hallelujah. Here's the reward I have for every conqueror, everyone who keeps at it. He's looking for you to keep at it, refusing to give up. You'll rule the nations. Your shepherd king rule as firm as an iron staff. They're resistant, fragile as clay pots. This was my gift my Father gave me, and I pass it along to you, and with it the morning stars. He that hath an ear, let him hear. Are your ears awake? Listen. Listen to the wind of the words of Spirit blowing through the church. Churches in Jesus' name. He is giving you the gift that our Father has given unto him in Jesus' name, that it is time for you to rule. Hallelujah. Even with the firm iron staff in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. It's time for you to refuse to give up. Hallelujah. You have been called to rule and to reign, to have dominion. Hallelujah. Take your authority, take your seat in the Lord. And you do that when you know whose you are. Earlier, he told me, he said, not only are you my daughter, not only are you a queen, we're kings and priests, right? But he said, hallelujah, you are also my warrior. You are his warrior, my son. You are his warrior, my daughter. Come on, somebody. And he is looking for you to hold on to what you have. Hallelujah. Don't give give up, to keep at it. In the name of Jesus, you are a conqueror, and he has a reward for every conqueror, and that's to pass on, hallelujah, the gift the Father gave him onto you in Jesus' name, and with it, the morning star. Come on, somebody, that's a good word. Hold on to what you have. Hold fast to what you have until he comes in the name of Jesus. Then he led me earlier. I started in Psalms chapter number 28. He wants me to read these verses for you as well. Psalms chapter number 28, 6-7 says, "But your name be blessed and built up, for you have answered my passionate cry for mercy." In Jesus' name, it's time to shift into praise and thank him. Hallelujah. For he has answered your passionate cry for mercy even tonight. And then the psalmist goes on to say, "You are my strength and my shield from every danger." He is. When I fully trust in you, help is on the way. When you fully trust in the Lord, your help is on the way. You jump for joy and burst forth with ecstatic, passionate praise. He is looking for you to jump for joy. This might be a good place. Just get up and jump for joy and burst forth with ecstatic, passionate praise. You will sing songs of what he means to you. Listen, it's time for you to get back to the heart of worship. I'm telling you. In the name of Jesus, Psalms chapter number 27, verse number 13. Says this, "I am still confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living." Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. That is what he is telling you tonight in the name of Jesus. I'm getting ready to pray. And then after that, I'm going to release this final scripture. He says, "The blessing of the Lord upon you in Jesus' name." And then we have a couple of songs we're going to get out of here and release prophetically over you as well in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you. Hallelujah. Even as we've been out here for 111. Hallelujah. That's indicating the time of transition. That's indicating the shift in the mighty name of Jesus. It's time for us to move in the name of the Lord. So Father, I thank you that you are in rendering even transition even now in the mighty name of the Lord. Father, I thank you. Hallelujah. As I speak this, even as you have given us conviction tonight, we ask that you would forgive us, Father, for operating, for moving in unforgiveness or a lack of trust in you. We ask that you would forget. We repent, Father, for not loving you the way we thought because we didn't trust in you, Father. We didn't trust that you had it all under control. Oh, but Father, you are taking over. You are taking over even right now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, Father, and according to your power, glory, and your authority, Jesus, hallelujah, I just speak against every spirit of depression. Hallelujah. I take authority over depression according to your will and your word and your plan and the blood of the Lamb in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. And I render it null. I render it void. I render it helpless. I render it. In Jesus' name, I render it unable to move. I render its assignment to be canceled even now in the name of Jesus. No longer will it impact the people of God in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, I rebuke all fiery darts of the devil right now in the name of Jesus. You will not penetrate me. Father, I thank you for your hedge of protection even now in the name of Jesus. I draw a bloodline in the name of Jesus, declaring that the enemy shall not come nigh in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, because the blood will overtake and overpower, and the consuming fire of Holy Spirit will deal with every demonic entity that tries to cross the bloodline in the name of Jesus. Father, I speak right now that you will be an enemy to my enemies in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, and every demonic entity that comes against your people or myself, Father, cut it off, cut its head off, mutilate it, destroy it completely in the name of Jesus. You are the God that answers by fire. Consume every spirit that's not of you in the name of Jesus. Paralyze every spirit that is not of you in the name of Jesus. They are no longer able able to walk or operate in the name of Jesus. Set your people free in their minds, in their hearts, and in their spirit in the name of Jesus. Remove all blinders. Remove the blindness in the name of Jesus. Remove the things that have been on their ears, Father, that they can hear clearly, that they can see clearly, that they will perceive clearly in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Spirit of heaviness, be broken off of your people right now in the name of Jesus. As they are holding on, they will no longer be in despair. Oh, Basa, a hope deferred makes a heart sick, but a promise fulfilled is a tree of life. No more deferred hope in the name of Jesus. No more hope deferred. No more hearts that are sick in the name of Jesus. But I decree and declare your power, hallelujah, your glory, your majesty in the name of Jesus. Father, reign, rule, abide, reside. In the name of Jesus, Father, we repent of everything not like you. We come into agreement with you, Father, and we say we will hold on. We will hold fast. We will hold out. We will hold tight. In the name of Jesus, we trust in the God of our salvation. In the name of Jesus, that you are great and you are God and that you are supreme over everything in the mighty name of Jesus. We will not be timid. We will not shrink back. Father, I thank you. Hallelujah. Even as we receive our weapons in the spirit by the spirit of the living God in the name of Jesus, and we declare forth your goodness and we declare forth your glory in the mighty name of the Lamb. Hallelujah. We declare that you are good and you are God in the name of Jesus. Amen. In the name of Jesus, raise up the war cry in your people in the name of Jesus, that they would cry loud and spare not as they take their power back in the name of Jesus, and that they would begin to speak like never before, that they would be able to speak to any entity that is not of you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, no more depression shall rule, no more spirit of suicide, no more suicidal ideation in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, just annihilate every enemy that comes against your people even tonight in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, stand strong in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In Jesus' mighty name, I thank you, Father. Father says he is putting a torch in your tongue. He is putting a torch in your tongue. When you open up your mouth, fire is going to come out. Fire, 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 fire. Fire, 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 fire. In the name of Jesus. You've been quiet too long. Come on. Father, may your warriors speak. May they render the war cry. They are champions for Christ. They are champions for you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And we've already won. We've already won in the name of Jesus. And so we will not be defeated. You are not defeated. We are not defeated in our mind. We are not defeated in our spirit. We are not defeated in our bodies. Oh, but we will declare forth the glory of the Lord in the name of Jesus. We will speak in alignment with what you have spoken in the mighty name of Jesus, Father. And we thank you now. Hallelujah. And we call everything that you've spoken done according to the will, purpose, and plan of the Lord. Father, things are moving. Things are shifting. In the name of Jesus, you are moving. You are working like never before. You are shifting it all. And you have great things for your people in the name of Jesus. And they trust and believe that their hope is in you. Their trust is in you. We love you, kind Father, in the name of Jesus. Shift mindset so they feel your love. They know that they are loved by you in the name of Jesus, and they will walk in your strength, your power, and your authority. Hallelujah. In which you died to give us back, Lord Jesus. Father, I thank you that your intention from the jump street when you created man, hallelujah, for us to have dominion, for us to rule, for us to walk in that authority, and also for us to multiply, for us to produce. And so no longer will we stay all bound up, but Father, we will stretch forth. We will expand the way that you have intended us to. We will multiply. We will declare forth your word, your promises, your prophecies, even now in the name of Jesus. Father, I speak strength to your people in the name of Jesus. Divine restoration. Hallelujah. They will not, you will not be silent. That song is coming to me right now. I will not be silent. I will always worship you. Hallelujah. I will not be silent. I will always worship you. I will always declare forth your goodness and your glory in the name of Jesus. Father, forgive us for forgetting who we were. Oh, Father, please forgive us. In Jesus' mighty name, hallelujah, may we call forth your goodness and your glory and your power, your strength, your might. You are faithful, and there is no one like thee in the name of Jesus, Father. And so I speak, hallelujah, to everything that has been held up, and I command that it be let go right now in the name of Jesus. Every dam that has tried to hold up the blessings of the people, it is broken right now in the name of Jesus. Every log is consumed by fire now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You are removing every obstacle even now in the name of Jesus. You are healing. You are healing spirits and minds and hearts. And hallelujah. You are healing souls. Hallelujah. You are healing from hurts and traumas and pain in the name of Jesus. Father, you are healing brokenness in the name of Jesus. You are healing. Hallelujah. No longer shall they be unforgiving in the name of Jesus. Father, I speak forgiveness to your people, over your people, and that their hearts would overflow with your love and express your forgiveness in the earth in the mighty name of Jesus. Healing, God, rejection has to lose its hold right now in the name of Jesus. Abandonment has to lose its hold right now in the name of Jesus. We denounce everything that is not like you, Father, in the name of Jesus. And as we denounce it, we also renounce it. And as we renounce it, and as we denounce everything that's not like you, kind Father, I thank you, hallelujah, that the door is being shut in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. But even before the door complete, right now, I declare that is even as you spoke, that is the enemy be caught, he has to restore sevenfold. And so I declare divine restoration even in this moment. Hallelujah. Even before that door shuts in the name of Jesus, I declare that the enemy must render unto you everything that is owed to you, because he has been caught. He must restore sevenfold even now in the name of Jesus. And some of you are going to come into, hallelujah, not just seven, hallelujah, but 30, 60, and 100 fold in the name of Jesus. You said you would restore us. Hallelujah. You would make it up to us, Father. I thank you, and I call it done even now in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you for strengthening every vessel that they shall hold on, hold tight, and hold out in the name of Jesus. I thank you, hallelujah, that you're rendering help tonight. Strength is in the room tonight. Hallelujah. Strength is in their room tonight. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Breakthrough is here. 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 It's not only here for you and your circumstance, your situation, and those you've been praying for, but breakthrough in your spirit and in your heart is here. No longer will you withhold of those places. No longer will you still be bottled up and bogged up in the name of Jesus, but breakthrough is here. I speak divine release even now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. No more managed pain. You're letting it go now in the name of Jesus. Cleanse us, Father. Even as it's removed, even as it's purged right now in the name of Jesus. Somebody, you are actually going to feel the need to go to the restroom. Maybe you're burping. Maybe you're yawning. In Jesus' name. But as you release, it's going to be released in Jesus' mighty name. No longer will you be bound up, backed up in Jesus' name. No longer will you be boggled down in the name of Jesus. But freedom is here. Freedom is here in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for every breakthrough. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. And even breakthrough on behalf of loved ones, even tonight in the name of Jesus, they're going to wake up different. Hallelujah. No longer holding on to those old things. Hallelujah. But breakthrough is here. Set free. Hallelujah. Set free. Delivered in the name of Jesus. No longer bound. No more chains holding me. My soul is resting. It's just a blessing. Praise the Lord. Lord, hallelujah, I'm free. I release that song upon those who are here tonight and those who are believing for divine breakthrough, healing, and restoration in the lives of others, even now in the name of Jesus. Breakthrough, hallelujah. And you will receive the call. You will receive the text, hallelujah, that something is just different, that something has changed, hallelujah. That is something just lifted, is broken off in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Freedom, freedom, hallelujah, hallelujah. Where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. I speak freedom unto the people in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 It ain't blew up. The Father is building a bridge. Hallelujah. Even unto that thing that he promised you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. There is a crossing over. Head at my side. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, kind Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Daddy. In Jesus' name we pray, we believe, we decree and declare it is so and so it is. Thank you. You're worthy. You're worthy of our praise. You're worthy of our worship. You're worthy of our honor. You're worthy of the glory. Hallelujah. We thank you tonight. We thank you tonight. We call it done right now by the power of the living God in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Listen, beloved, I thank our Father for all of those of you who have joined us tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. And I still have, thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Daddy. We're listening. We're subject to you. We're surrendered to you. We're submitted to you. Have your way. This is your broadcast. Hallelujah. May you be glorified in all that we say and do in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Before we read our scripture, listen, if you don't follow me, make sure you follow me on Periscope, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Haps, and YouTube, all at Lady JereMia, so that you don't miss a broadcast. Make sure your notifications are on. So that you can be alerted when we're on in Jesus' name. And in case, you know, one app is doing something different, make sure that you're following us so that if there's something that resonated with your spirit, so you can make sure you get the word that Father has to release to you through our voice in Jesus' name. It's not about me having a million followers. It's about me making the name of Jesus famous, hallelujah, and him being able to move in the lives of his people. So you help me do that, and I appreciate you, hallelujah. And then also for those of you, somebody asked earlier to put up our sowing information. So if you feel led to sow into this word, you can do that at paypal.me/LadyJereMia. Also Venmo at Lady JereMia, or Cash App is $MMANA1, $MMANA1. And so I'm grateful to those of you. If you are led, be blessed of the Lord. And, you know, just know all of you who are here, I love you. Now, listen, this is the scripture that Father wanted me to release over you and prophesy over you even now in the name of Jesus. He's saying to give you this one first. It says in Psalms chapter number 37, verse number 3, keep trusting in the Lord and do what is right in his eyes. Keep trusting in the Lord and do what is right in his eyes, not in your own eyes. Fix your heart on the promises of God and you will be secure. Remember, he talked about fixed focus, hallelujah, having that fixed focus, that fixed faith. And he says, Fix your heart on the promise of God and you will be secure. Feasting on his faithfulness. Come on, you're going to feast on his faithfulness. I want you to eat, you know, allow yourself to be nourished by his faithfulness in Jesus' name. And so listen, it goes on to say, make God the utmost delight and pleasure of your life, and he will provide for you what you desire the most. Come on, somebody, give God the right to direct your life. And as you trust him along the way, you'll find he pulled it off perfectly. As you trust him along the way, you'll find he pulled it off perfectly. Can I tell somebody tonight? You're going to find that our Father has pulled it off perfectly in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Another translation says that he will bring it to pass. Commit your way to the Lord and he will bring it to pass in Jesus' name. Listen, and so Psalms chapter number 27, and I'm going to read that in verse number 13 through 14 in the Passion Translation as well. If you want to go with me to that, you can do that. Psalm 27, 13, verse number 14 as well in the Passion Translation reads as thus, and it says, yet I totally trust you to rescue me one more time. Some of you, you just need, he's going to do it again. Some of you are like, God, if you would just do it again. And the Father says, hallelujah, that he is going to do it again. You were like, even as the psalmist is declaring, yet I totally trust you to rescue me one more time so that I can see once again how good you are while I am still alive. Listen, you're going to see how good God is while you are still alive. You're going to see it once again. And I believe for many of you, you're going to see a shift even now. Hallelujah. Because it's happening overnight, but you're going to get the confirmation before Friday or by Friday in the name of Jesus. Listen, here's what I've learned through it all. Don't give up. Don't be impatient. Be entwined as one with the Lord. Hallelujah. Entwined as one with the Lord. Spend time with him so you can become one with the Lord. Be brave and courageous and never lose hope. Be brave and courageous and never lose hope. This is why you got to hold on. You got to trust in him. You endure to the end in Jesus' name. Those are the ones who win. Then says, yes, keep on waiting for he will never disappoint you. Those of you who are still in the wait, I encourage you. Hallelujah, to keep on waiting, for Father will never disappoint you in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. And so I release that over you and upon you even tonight in the mighty name of Jesus, knowing that he is faithful, that promise, he is going to do everything that he spoke in Jesus' name. Now I have a couple of songs to release to you all. If you want to hang on in here, if you have to go, you got to go. And so I just want to release these prophetically over you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. 132:30. Come on. He is lining things up in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Thank you, kind Father. Hallelujah. Thank you. Have your way. Hallelujah. I don't know if you guys ever heard this song before. I don't know. He was just operating through all the throwbacks tonight. So it's been a minute. We want to release this.